Hello, welcome to this session on phenotypic drug susceptibility testing in tuberculosis. I am Dr. Gomati from the National Institute for Research in Tuberculosis, Chennai. Let's first look at the usefulness of drug susceptibility tests, which is in short called as the DST. DST offers guidance to design a suitable regimen at the time of treatment initiation or for change of regimen during treatment when the patient is failing treatment. It enables detection of emerging acquired drug resistance in a patient who is on treatment. It provides information on the level of resistance to the drug and level of cross resistance among the same class of drugs and prevalence of resistance in any geographical setting. It enables recalculation of the epidemiological cutoff values that may necessitate the need to alter the drug concentrations used in the in vitro tests. So, any phenotypic DST compares growth in the presence and absence of the drug, which could be by direct visualization of the growth, example being the DST using solid media or the microscopically observed drug susceptibility test, or by means of demonstration of enzymes and metabolic products, example being the nitrate reductase test, or by indirect measurement of growth based on oxygen depletion in the medium, example being the MIGIT 960 DST, or by indirect measurement of growth based on redox dye based color changes, example being the microscopic Alamar blue assay. We will be looking at all these tests in detail in the coming slides. So, where are these phenotypic DST tests available? They are available only in the reference laboratories because of the requirement for the biosafety level 3 facilities. The time to result may be up to 42 days for solid media using DST or up to 14 days for liquid DST. A significant amount of skill and training are required, and the DST may cost anything between 1500 to 2500 per test. The media that are used for phenotypic DST could be solid media, examples being the Lowenstein-Jensen medium or the Middlebrook 7H10 or 7H11 media, or it could be liquid media where in-house prepared Middlebrook 7H medium can be used, or the commercial liquid media can be used in commercial systems. The solid medium based DST methods include the minimum inhibitory concentration method, in short known as the MIC method, or the resistance ratio method, or the proportion susceptibility testing method, which is in short known as the PST method. The MIC method determines the minimal concentration of the drug that inhibits the growth of the organism. A standard suspension is taken and a uniform volume is inoculated onto the drug-free and drug-containing media. The slopes are incubated at 37 degrees C for about 28 days, and growth between the drug medium and the drug free medium is compared, and interpretation is based on the standard recommended cutoff values for the respective drugs, example being for isoniazid acid it is 0.2 microgram per ml and for rifampicin it is 32 microgram per ml. The factors that may affect the MIC method are preparation of the medium, because for this test when the medium is being prepared, a stock solution of the drug is prepared and dilutions are made to finally achieve the different concentration of the drug in the slopes, and any errors in the preparation of the medium can result in erroneous results. Second is the preparation of suspension. We require a uniform suspension here, and presence of even a small clump in the suspension can result to wrong results. And third is the variation in the inoculum size between the slopes. This can also affect the results. And finally, the technical errors which could result in interpretation errors. Next, we come to the resistance ratio method, which is defined as the MIC of the test to MIC of the standard laboratory strain, which is the H37RV. This is generally used for streptomycin, and the factors that could affect this method could be the age of the cells, whether it is a test strain or the standard strain, and variations in the MIC of the standard strain due to repeated passages of the strain in the laboratory. The MIC method is set up for both the test and the standard strain as usual, as it is performed in the MIC method. And the MIC of the test, the resistance ratio is determined by MIC of the test divided by the MIC of RV. When the RR is 2 or less, the strain is considered to be sensitive to streptomycin. When an RR of 4, it is considered to be doubtful when the test has to be repeated. An RR of 8 or more than that, is the strain is considered to be resistant to streptomycin. Next, we come to the proportion sensitivity testing, which is a PST method. This is currently the method of choice employed in NTPs or the National Tuberculosis Programs, where the solid method of DST is still being performed. This method offers precise estimation of the proportion of resistant mutants. The use of a single concentration of a drug is utilized in this methodology, which is usually the critical concentration. 10-fold dilutions of the uniform suspension is planted onto drug-free and drug-containing media. The slopes are indicated incubated up to 42 days, and with an interim reading being done on the day 28. Growth in drug-free and drug-containing media is compared, and strains expressing 1% or more of the resistant mutants are classified as resistant. Here, the resistance, any resistance observed may be reported on day 28, and the reading has to be repeated on day 42 in the case of drug susceptible strains. The factors that are affecting the PST could be similar to other methods, and since we are preparing dilutions of the suspension here, any small clump in the suspension can lead to erroneous results and wrong results. So, since we are counting the colonies in the slopes here, fusion of colonies could lead to errors in counting, and also the potency and the expiry period of the drug can also affect the PST method results. Now, we move on to drug susceptibility testing by Midget 960. The principle is similar to PST, where a fixed manufacturer's protocol has to be followed. It is a qualitative test with a turnaround time of between 4 to 13 days. A primary culture is required. This could be either from LJ or from Midget. A single concentration of the drug is used. The continuous monitoring of the tubes is equipped with software-based auto output of interpreted results. These are the concentrations that are employed in Midget 960 DST. In addition to these recommended methods, WHO has approved of other DST methods. These are non-commercial methods. These methods are recommended under clearly defined program and operational conditions in reference laboratories and under strict laboratory protocols and as an interim solution while capacity for genotypic or automated liquid culture and DST is being developed. Examples of these assays are the MODS or the nitrate reductase assay, which can be used for direct detection of DST from the sample or indirectly from culture isolate. The colorimetric redox indicator dye based tests are to be used only from culture isolate, but none of these methods are to be employed for XDR detection. So, direct DST by nitrate reductase test. This is based on the ability of MTB to reduce nitrate to nitrite. The substrate nitrate is included in the medium which is prepared with and without drugs. Reduction to nitrite is indicated by color changes using specific reagents, and the color changes indicate growth in addition to visual detection of colonies. Single concentration of drug is used in this methodology. The results are available in 7 to 14 days. The technique is inexpensive, and high levels of sensitivity and specificity with cultures is observed for first line anti-TB drugs. The test can be done on sputum directly for isoniazid and rifampicin DST. Next, we come to MODS methodology, which is the microscopic observation of drug susceptibility employed using in-house prepared 7H medium, 7H9 medium in a 24-well plate format. Sputum is decontaminated and a uniform volume is added to drug-free and drug-containing medium in the wells, and growth is exhibited by characteristic cord formation, which is observed under inverted microscope. This methodology can be used for direct detection, drug susceptibility and identification of MTB directly from samples. This requires skill, but it is relatively inexpensive. This is highly prone for contamination and biosafety issues, hence BSL-3 facilities are required for this. Next is rapid DST using colorimetric assays. Here, this is based on measurement of color changes occurring in the medium due to redox changes resulting out of microbial growth. The first one is using MTT, which is dimethyl thiazole diphenyl tetrazolium bromide, which is originally yellow in color but gets reduced to purple formazone by the dehydrogenase enzyme in the cell. This methodology is used mainly for detection of rifampicin resistance using clinical isolates and specimens. The next one is the Alamar blue assay, which is again a redox dye. This turns pink due to oxygen depletion in the medium resulting out of microbial growth. This is used for DST as well as for screening compounds for anti-TB activities. The third one is rhizazurin, which is a component of Alamar blue. The principle is the same. Now, all these methodologies are simple, rapid, and both visual and spectrophotometric readings are possible. All these methodologies are highly prone for contamination and require BSL-3 facilities. They also have difficulty in interpreting borderline resistances. The key messages from this session are that all formats have advantages and disadvantages. All DST activities require BSL-3 facilities. Formats using commercial media are expensive. Assays such as MIC, PST, resistance ratio, MODS and MABA, which make use of in-house prepared media, are cheaper, but they are labor intensive and offer delayed results. All are prone to contamination and interpretation errors. And inclusion of a standard strain and quality control is mandatory for all these techniques, and it is preferable for the lab to get involved in an external quality assurance program to ensure proficiency. With this, we come to the end of this session on phenotypic DST methodologies. Thank you for your attention.